Hi there, Doug Stuman with IT Creations with the Gigabyte R282-P91 server. What makes this system unique is support for not an Intel Xeon Scalable processor and not an AMD EPYC processor, but an Ampere Altra MAX CPU. In fact, there are two of them on the system board, each of which support 96 to 128 physical cores. This is a cloud-native platform that also supports up to 8 terabytes of memory with 24 2.5-inch Gen4 NVMe drive bays up front and more in back. This platform is designed for networking applications like file storage, uses a virtual server, file access via VPN, a shared internet connection, and other applications. Let's take a look. First, some information about Ampere Altra Max processors. This is actually the second generation from Ampere. The previous generation was just Ampere Altra without the Max and delivered 32 to 80 cores. This processor has a system-on-chip ARM architecture with a reduced instruction set computer architecture, or RISC, if you like acronyms. ARM means Advanced RISC Machine. Other more familiar processors, x86 processors, have a CISC, or Complex Instruction Set, computer architecture. RISC architecture offers a reduced instruction set, but still delivers great performance with less power. Those CISC architecture CPUs have prioritized performance and throughput over power consumption, and in general produce more heat. As a general statement, ARM CPUs consume significantly less power, and as a result produce less heat than what Ampere is calling a legacy x86 ecosystem, meaning old and outdated, I'm assuming. As a result of less power consumed and less heat generated, they offer a quick ROI with savings on power and cooling. They still offer performance, scalability, and sustainability. In fact, x86 processors, while very popular for servers, are not widely used in phones and laptops, which utilize ARM-based designs. Who knew? Well, probably some of you geeks did. The second generation Ampere Altra Max CPU features a 7-nanometer architecture with 1 megabyte L2 cache per core, 8-memory channel architecture, and PCI 4.0 with 128 lanes per CPU. With dual processors, there are 192 PCI lanes available. PCI lanes can also be bifurcated to by 4. These are single-threaded cores, so no hyper-threading technology or CPU core virtual mirroring. The cores operate at a consistent and predictable frequency of up to 3 gigahertz, with memory speeds of up to 3,200 megatransfers per second supported. Perhaps I should mention one last thing. Ampere has already released another CPU that delivers 136 to 192 cores, has twice the L2 cache per core at 2 megabytes, 8 memory channel architecture with DDR5 supported, and 128 lanes of PCI 5.0 with wattages ranging from 200 watts to 350 watts, which is definitely in line with what is consumed by Intel and AMD CPUs. That said, I'm not sure where we are going with this power savings thing. That third gen CPU is not supported on this platform. Are you interested in the Gigabyte R282-P91 server? Just use that link to visit itcreations.com. For a limited time, you can save up to $500 off a system listed or one that you can configure on our site that's valued at $5,000 or more.
You will never find a more wretched hive of scum and villainy.
Wait, that's the wrong clip. I think you get the idea. On the hardware. The platform has 24 storage bays up front with support for Gen 4 NVMe storage devices. There are 4 more storage bays in back, but we will get to that in a minute. The left server ear has several LEDs and buttons. Starting at the top, a reset button, power on button with LED, hard drive status LED with LAN 1 LED on the left and LAN 2 LED on the right. Above that, a system status LED and then an ID button with LED. The right server ear is outfitted with dual USB 3.0 ports. It features a pretty typical Gigabyte design. The back of the server has dual redundant 1600 watt 80 plus platinum PSUs to either side, each with a drive cage above that that supports 2.5 inch SATA drive formats. Right next to each of those PSUs is a mezzanine card slot, which in this case, both are disabled and appear to be used for support of the upfront NVMe drives with additional PCIe connections. In the middle, there is a mini display port, 2 USB 3.0 ports, 2 gigabit Ethernet ports, and a server management LAN port, PCI slots above. That RJ45 LAN port connects to the integrated ASPEED AST2600 baseboard management controller, just like on other Gigabyte systems. This system is also compatible with Gigabyte's integrated management console for managing a single server. The Gigabyte management console has the AMI MegaRack SPX web interface and tracks server health, offers remote troubleshooting, provides resource monitoring, and helps reduce server downtime, given you can access the system from anywhere. It can also easily integrate with other third-party management applications for ease of use. for multiple servers, there's the Gigabyte Server Management, or GSM software, compatible with IPMI 2.0 and Redfish. GSM leverages the Gigabyte Management Console through the Gigabyte GSM Agent, which is installed on every server. There is also GSM Mobile and a plugin from Compatible with VMware vCenter. All good, and for my favorite price for goods and services, free. Inside the case, oh wait, one more thing. Standard Windows-based operating systems do not support ARM architecture at this time and are not supported on this platform. That said, there are quite a few Linux-based operating systems to choose from. Inside the case, it has a standard layout with drives up front, then four fans, CPUs and memory module slots, then the power supplies to either side with PCI risers in the middle. There are several connectors for the NVMe drives up front, which are scattered around the motherboard. The reason those OCP card slots are unavailable is because eight more storage connectors are provided by the circuit boards on those OCP slots with four slots per card. A PCIe Gen 4x4 slot between the risers is for an NVMe M.2 drive. The M.2 supports up to 4 terabytes of memory and can be used to boot the system or for additional superfast storage. Each of the processors supported on this system support either 96, 112, or 128 cores for up to 256 physical cores with both sockets outfitted with 128-core CPUs. This system is outfitted with dual 128-core Ampere Altra MAX 64-bit M128-30 CPUs with a base frequency of 2.8 GHz and a maximum boost frequency of 3.0 GHz, and a top TDP of 250 watts. As mentioned before, these processors provide consistent, reliable power. Both processors support 16 memory modules each for 32 slots total and a maximum memory capacity of up to 8 terabytes. Memory supported includes registered and load-reduced ECC memory modules with a capacity of 256 gigabytes and a memory speed of up to 3200 megahertz. With two risers in back, there are four full-height, half-length PCIe Gen 4x16 slots, with two in each riser. I will mention that one of those slots in each of the risers is disabled on those two. As a networking server, these slots are primarily used for additional network controller interfaces, and there are several to choose from. In this case, as the OCP mezzanine card slots are not an option, those 4x16 PCIe slots supported in the two risers will provide connections for PCIe-based NICs. Installed in one of those risers for this build is an Intel X710 DAS CNA with dual 10 gigabit Ethernet SFP Plus ports. Although you can certainly go with various other connection speeds and link options, including single or dual port 200 gigabit Ethernet QSFP and QSFP56 respectively. There's also a Broadcom MegaRAID 9560-16i controller suitable for 32 NVMe Gen 4 devices or up to 240 SAS SATA per controller. It offers RAID support for critical high bandwidth applications with RAID levels of 0, 00, 1, 5, 6, 10, 50, and 60. That's right off their data sheet. It's a tri-mode controller, so it supports SAS, SATA, or NVMe in any bay. For data center and cloud deployments, this system offers fairly dense storage at 2U, along with reduced power and cooling costs for a lower total cost of ownership. With up to 28 drive bays and M.2 supporting the OS, it's also a great addition to an on-site network for additional quick access hot storage. If you have any questions, post them in the comments section below. For more information, you can also click one of those links there or one in the description below. And remember to hit that subscribe button and check out itcreations.com for all of your IT needs. Till next time, I'm Doug Stuman with IT Creations, and thanks for watching.